Oh my gosh. Good evening and welcome to Wednesday Night Wellness Live. I'm Dr. Andrew Merrill here at Nightlight Chiropractic in downtown Orlando. And this is our video that we do each week live. So here I am live. That basically showcases the questions and commentary that we're getting from patients on a weekly basis. So we see about 150 to 175 patients per week here in the office between Dr. Bass and myself. And there's a lot of common themes that we hear, a lot of the similar questions that we hear week in, week out, as it pertains to health and wellness, right? So people come in with the same exact questions or similar questions that we end up answering again and again and again. And so we do these videos not just because the answers are very similar when you go person to person, but also because I'm sure you out there, the viewer, if you haven't been to our office, or maybe even if you haven't, you were just a little bit too shy to ask, have the same questions, right? So what we've realized is that everyone is asking these same questions and has these same concerns. They're looking for a trusted source. That would be me. I like to think that I'm trusted by some of you out there. Anyways, I'm told that I have no sound here. Can you hear me now? Better? Worse? Better? Is it coming through now? Can you hear me? I hope you can hear me out there. Actually, why don't we do this? What if I did this? Then you could probably hear me better. I'm going to do this without a microphone. So, we get the same questions each week, and this week what we're going to talk about is mattresses, right? So every week we hear patients ask us, what mattress should I be sleeping on? What do you recommend as far as mattresses? What do you recommend as far as like where to purchase mattresses? So this is going to clear up everything so that, thank you, Miss Amanda. I'm glad that you can hear me now. So we're going to clean up, this video is going to help to clean up all of it so that we give you soup to nuts, everything about mattresses. So let's start with your mattress. Would you put your mattress up against your couch? Is your mattress more comfortable than your couch? What about, is it more comfortable than your previous mattress? Is it more comfortable than maybe a hotel mattress that you stayed on? Would you put your mattress up against that? So you're gonna spend roughly a third of your life on your mattress. It's something that you should actually take a dedicated approach to. You should be doing some homework here. You should be thinking about this. This should be a financial decision and a well thought out idea about what I'm gonna do and why I'm gonna do it, because you're gonna spend a lot of time on this thing, right? And you want it to be at least as good as that hotel mattress when you sleep on it. So this question that we get all the time doesn't have a simple answer about which mattress is best for you, but it does have some common themes to it, right? So one of those common themes is, which position do you sleep in, right? Are you a side sleeper? Are you a face down sleeper? Are you a sleep on your back sleeper? If you're a stomach sleeper, you need to stop that immediately, okay? So we can just kind of scratch that out right there. If you sleep on your stomach, there's lots of good quality research that shows that you shouldn't be sleeping on your stomach. It actually reduces the amount of sagittal curves you have in your spine. So that's the curves that you're supposed to have in your neck, middle back, and lower back. And you need to get rid of those. You don't want to get rid of those. It's really important that you don't get rid of those. You can't sleep face down because you need those curves to keep functioning. I got a question here from Mr. David Francis. Hello, doc. I just received a MyPillow. Do they help with headaches? That's a tough answer that there's probably no research on. I would not say that they specifically help with headaches. However, I'm a fan of the MyPillow. And one of the reasons I'm a fan of the MyPillow, and this is a little bit off topic and maybe getting ahead of us, but I'm glad that you asked it, Mr. Francis. I hope you're still up there in Detroit and I hope it's getting warmer for you. Is that the MyPillow, you can adjust the amount of substance in it, right? So it has a zipper on it so that you can pull out some of the foam stuffing. If it's too much for you, you can actually adjust the thickness of your MyPillow. So keep that in mind when you're using it, that if it feels like it's pushing your head up too much or it's too dense or too firm, you can remove some of the filling to make it work better for you. Okay, so back to where I was. You can't sleep face down. Stop that immediately. If you insist on sleeping face down, like you cannot quit that habit, it's just you and you're gonna do it, you gotta have a soft pillow and a really firm mattress. And that's gonna be the best for you. So if you insist on sleeping face down, you don't have to, there's ways out of this, but you wanna have a really soft pillow and a really firm mattress. If you sleep on your back, that's good. I like it a lot. What you need is a medium firm mattress. That's the most common recommendation I give, is get a medium firm mattress. If you spend part of the night or the majority of the night on your back, that is what you're gonna want, is a medium firm mattress and a medium firm pillow. Now, sleeping on your side is actually the best for your back. I'm sorry, let me skip back real quick. If you sleep on your back, you can sleep with a pillow underneath your knees, but you cannot sleep with a pillow underneath your back.
This is important. Let me put this home for you again. If you sleep on your back, you can have a pillow underneath your knees, but you cannot have a pillow underneath your lower back. A lot of people have been telling us that they feel comfortable like that, or that they seem to sleep better like that, but it's unnaturally causing some extra hyperlordosis, some extra curvature in your lower back, and it will not serve you well. That's gonna cause more pain. So underneath your knees, not underneath your lower back. The most preferred sleeping position as far as chiropractors go and for your back is on your side. We want you to be sleeping on your side. What you want is a pillow in between your knees when you're sleeping on your side. Again, you want a soft to medium mattress depending on how much shoulder pain you get when you're sleeping on your side. That's a common complaint that we hear, is that it's too much tension on your shoulder. If you have a slightly less firm mattress, that's going to help you so that you can sleep a little bit better without deforming your spine. So sleeping on your side, you want a slightly softer mattress than if you sleep on your back. So where should you get this mattress and what should it be made of, right? So again, we hear this all the time is, well, should I get the memory foam? Should I get the spring mattress? Should I get the latex mattress, air mattress, waterbed? Let's go over all of them here one at a time. So traditional spring mattress is what most people had up until very recently, and it's fine. They still do very well. They have a lot of mattress toppers and pads that are already put onto them. The one downside, I think, if there was one, for traditional spring mattresses is that you can't flip them once they start to lose their shape and deform. And understand this, for every simple type of substance that we're going to mention, they all fail eventually, okay? If you look at the best research that's coming out of the industry, and it's all out of the industry, right? So everything you read has been done by a mattress company, and it's mattress company research. So you take it all with a grain of salt, but you do your best to kind of put it all together. Is that all mattresses fail. It takes about 7 to 15 years. It's based on how much sag you get, which they say if it gets to about 1.5 inches of sag, then the mattress has failed. However, what we know from some other research that is not done by the mattress company is that you'll start to feel increased back pain if your mattress sags half of that, which is 0.75 inches. So realistically, every 7 to 15 years, you're going to need to update your mattress. So price does become an issue. I had a question here from Miss Amanda. What are your thoughts on replacing a mattress topper instead of the mattress itself? What type of mattress toppers are preferred? So I like the idea, except that the problem is that the mattress will also lose its shape and deform. So you might be able to get away with that a little bit, but really what you're gonna end up doing is replacing a mattress topper and making it more and more firm to make up for the fact that the mattress sags. It's probably chasing your tail in circles a little bit. I don't know if I can necessarily recommend that. There's too many what-ifs that go into that scenario. Could you get away with it once maybe? Like, oh, I don't want to replace my mattress right this second. I'm going to try and limp along. Yeah, maybe. But can you do it again and again and again? Probably not so. Not so much. Excuse me. All right, so after that sag starts to happen, you got to replace your mattress anyways. The problem with the spring mattress is you can't flip it over, so that's the downside of the spring mattress. Other than that, just fine, good for a budget, and there's nothing, absolutely nothing wrong with the spring mattress. My choice is memory foam, and it's because this has come way down in price and way up in quality over the past 5, 6, 7 years. You can get these things all over the internet, shipped very, very cheaply, and like I said, the quality has gotten much better. A couple different issues with the memory foam mattresses. Some of the older ones, they say that you're not supposed to have children sleeping on or small infants sleeping on because they sink into it just a little bit, and then they can't turn or twist, and then they get stuck and can die. So you don't want small children on these older memory foam mattresses. And the other thing is gas is being expelled from the mattress. So if you've ever bought one of these, you understand what I'm saying. But once you open these things up, they start to release a smell, like noxious fumes. And it's really strong for some mattresses, and some people are a little bit less tolerant of it. And it's unpleasant, let's say. It's not dangerous, it's just unpleasant. So that's the downside of those memory foam mattresses that you should be buying in the medium firm density, because they get real soft once you order a soft memory foam mattress. The other thing about those is if you order something that's too thin, so they sell them in different sizes, something like a 6-inch or an 8-inch memory foam mattress is not going to be enough support for you. There's just not enough density for those smaller ones. So it needs to be something at least 10 inches thick or more, 12, 15 inches, that's going to have enough thickness to make it so that it has support for you. So memory foam is good. Let's see, air mattresses like Sleep Number is another one that we talk about all the time. How are Sleep Number mattresses? We hear a lot of good anecdotal reports back from patients saying that these are the best, these are fantastic. So aside from the price, because they get very pricey very quickly, even the off-brand air mattresses, they're really good for couples, right? So if husband needs a side sleeping softer mattress, wife is a back sleeper and she needs a firmer mattress, it's a good way that you can get the best of both worlds because they do independent air suspensions that allow you to have the best in one mattress. Another good option, despite the price. The last thing is waterbeds. And the waterbeds are great for the 1970s, but they're bad for backs. So if you are still sleeping on a waterbed, get rid of it. It needs to go. It is bad for your spine. It is not one of your options. Make sure that it goes and does not come back. So again, like I said in the beginning part of this video, you want to do your homework on some of this stuff though, right? You want to read all the reviews. There are tons of reviews out there. Look for independent personal reviews. People who have bought this mattress, who are not getting paid to give you their position or their what they think of this mattress. It's really important. It's really important that you get to try this mattress, right? If you have the option, you want to try to see if you like it, right? If you get a chance to sleep on it for 30 days and it has a warranty that allows you to return it, that's really important to make sure that you're not buying something that you don't like that you can't sleep well on. I got another question here. The best temp for sleeping, and this, the best temperature for sleeping plays a big role because your body temperature needs to decrease just a little bit, about 1 degree, so that you can actually get to sleep. So it becomes really important. So a lot of these mattresses now don't hold as much heat as they used to. And that's across the board. They're getting smarter with this technology. They're getting smarter with the different fabrics and materials that they're making it out of, so that even the latex mattresses that used to be notorious for holding in heat do not hold that heat the same anymore. So probably not such an issue when it comes to picking the mattress, how much heat it holds, unless you're buying an older mattress somewhere. But I think across the board, at least from the homework that I did, it's not as much of an issue anymore. But like I'm saying, do the homework, right? You might read some reviews. Well, this mattress said that it didn't hold in heat as much, but it does, and I didn't like it. You're only going to get that from the reviews. The other thing is there used to only be like a handful of mattress companies, right? I mean, there was like Tempur-Pedic and maybe like Sleep Number, and that was it, or maybe Sealy or Serta or something like that. There's a whole new guard of mattress companies out there, things that you've probably seen, branded right here on Facebook, Casper, Purple, Nola, Level Sleep, Bear. They're all reputable companies. I mean, they're selling millions of mattresses. It's worth your time to investigate those just as much, especially because they have an online presence that means they're going to ship their mattress to you. And because of that, they have great warranties to stand behind those products, meaning that if you don't like it after 90 days or 120 days, you can ship it right back. And a lot of the box stores don't have warranties like that anymore. So again, do your homework. Make sure that it fits your budget. More expensive doesn't always mean better. It just means more expensive. But don't let price hold you back too much, because if it's something that you're going to spend a third of your life on and you're going to have it for 15 years, that means you're going to get 5 years out of it. That's more than just about anything else that you're going to buy, save maybe your home. So take the time and do the research on it. Take the time and spend the dollars on it. It's going to serve you really well into the future. I hope that that answers some of your questions about mattresses here, or my thoughts on what mattresses you should get based on your sleep position and kind of who you are. Keep in mind too, it's not an exact science, right? I mean, it changes based on other things. If you have back pain, what kind of back pain you have, your body habitus, like kind of your size and shape, your age, it all plays a big role into it as well. So these are just some kind of ground strokes for you. That's all I have for this evening. Thank you for joining me for Wednesday Night Wellness Live. I will see you again next week. Have a wonderful week and good night.